Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. So my question for last week was, which tractor do you want me to buy? Do you want me to buy the International 1255, which is just going up through there? I have hired the original cultivator, that you know, the one that we started the map with. So the one that you start Bjornholm with, you know, that little small one? It actually was too big for the very small tractors, but I've hired that one, I've hired a front weight for that tractor, and he is plugging away doing some cultivating. So that was one option, and the other one was the Ford TW30. Now, I gotta be honest, that it has been really, really close, the votes on this. It sort of swung towards International, then everybody wanted the Ford, and then sort of gone back towards the International a bit, and then sort of the... So, it sort of evened out a bit. To be honest, it's a very difficult call to make. It looks like, fractionally, the Ford is actually the one that's come out on top. But I've had so many votes either way, I'm tempted to go for both. But I'm going to get the Ford first, because that does seem to be the one that has had the most votes. Not by a long way, not by a huge amount, but it does seem to have just marginally had the most votes. And I might move that tractor into another field in a minute, and we're going to run through here. So my question for this week, now you're probably, some of you are aware by now that Melbury Estate, I am wrapping that up this week. That is the final week. We have already had the final episode, and I'm starting a new map, because we've only got about 10 weeks left until FS17 comes out. Now I would like to play this map a little bit more, but I don't know if we've got 30 episodes worth of content left in this. It's going to take us to well over 50 episodes, which is a long time to run a map that we're so limited on the types of machinery that we can run on it. So I'm asking you the question, do you want next week to be my final week? Do you want me to run this one for another 4 weeks? And that would leave, I would estimate, 6 weeks, so 24 episodes on another map. Or do you want me to just stick with this one until Farming Simulator 17 comes out and run another 50-odd episodes on this map, which I personally think would be a bit dull? So that is my question. Do you want me to do this week plus next week, so that'll be 6 episodes from today? Do you want me to do 4 weeks, so another 2 weeks on top of that? Or do you want me to just stick with this map until Farming Simulator 17 comes out? Which tractor? I did come back here for a particular reason. I came for this tractor here, actually. I would personally prefer to run this map for another couple of weeks and then move on to another map. That would give me about 8 weeks to run a new series. But obviously, it is your vote, it is your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know which you would prefer. I'm not sure what map I'm going to do next to replace this one. I won't actually put that up for a vote. That's not going to be something that I'm going to offer as a vote. It's just, I'm going to find a map that I think would be suitable. And what I think I will actually do is, I won't go for a big map. I'll go for quite a small map. Now, I've been told that Old Streams or Two Streams or something like that is actually a really good one. And it's a very small map with a lot of very small fields. So you tend to want to use much smaller machinery. And I would quite like to do that. That, I think, would be quite entertaining. I won't limit the age of the machinery. I'll just use smaller stuff. So now, can I take this one down that way? That's going right through the village with the twin wheels on. Better to go the other way. You know what? Let's go through the village. I'd like to take this one down here. We've got a grass field right there. I'm going to see if we can maneuver this one down through the town with the twin wheels on. So, excuse me, people. Coming through. This thing is fantastic. I'm just going to move this one down to the next field so that we can set it up ready for ploughing. I don't know if I'm going to do very much with it, though. Because we've got other things that I'd like to do. I gathered up some of the grass with the Ford up there. I also I need to thank someone, because he has pointed out a few little problems that I was having. I did find the manure and the slurry in the end for the cows. That's back in behind the sheds. We couldn't find them originally. But those have been discovered. And right, I am very sorry, person. I'm just going to have to drive through you. I also found the wood chips. Hang on, I do have a note here somewhere. Where is it? No, You know, I really should have had this ready, so I'm going to... Oh, there it is. Sorry, I did have it ready. Right, it's Martin Johansson. I think I'm pronouncing that right. I believe he's not actually English, so it wouldn't be Johansson. I believe it's Johansson. So Martin Johansson is the one that told me where the wood chips are stored, and I am so grateful for him, to him for that, because that is absolutely brilliant. It means that I can actually access the wood chips now. And that is going to make a massive, massive difference. So I am going to, you know what, I'm not actually going to use this now, because I would like to go on and do the other stuff that I wanted to do. So let's stop you. The International will have finished as well. They can wait until next episode. I've got loads of stuff ready for seeding, but I'm not going to do that either. There's something else that I wanted to do today. So I'm going to go and get this tractor up here that I got and started up and meet you up at the cattle yard. As we're driving up past that shed there, you can see the heap just in there, I think. That is the wood chips. That is where Martin Johansson pointed out that the wood chips are stored. I could have been looking for that for ages. I know I parked the baler in there, but I don't know where... Well, I am going to be using the baler soon, but I wouldn't have been... I probably wouldn't have found them for quite a while. So it's nice to know that they're there and we've got them that we can use. We'll get a bucket on the front loader on the BM Volvo, and we can carry a few bucketfuls of wood chips from there over to the beehive mod. I will probably do that tomorrow, actually. And there's one other thing that I was going to do. I was actually... Today's question was originally going to be about feeding technology, because I'm going to go make some hay now, and I found this mixer wagon. It is a little bit pricey, but I mean, compared to the others, it's quite cheap. That is quite an old looking mixer wagon. I'm not very happy with the mod though. It does seem a little bit glitchy on the graphics. They sort of flicker a lot, and I have said before, I'm very, very snobby when it comes to my mods. I want them to be perfect. So I wasn't overly happy about that one anyway. I will use it because it's the only older one that I can find, and I wasn't going to actually use one of the Coon ones if I could get away with it. So I will use that one, but it's not the best mod that I have found. It's quite basic, and the person who made it did say that it is basic. It's one of their first ones. So, you know, we will forgive them for that for this time, and hopefully their modding will improve as time goes on. Like I said, I am a bit of a snob, and I apologise if it upsets people that I say things like this, but I like my mods to be absolutely perfect, and I do judge harshly. So let me just have a look here. Now, I want this one in windrower mode. I have put plenty of grass up there. We'll go and have a look at that in a bit. Go a bit closer. Come on. I had it just now. It came up. We've not used windrower. I want tedder mode. That one. There we go. Look at that. So... I've sort of picked up half of this field, and I'm going to do the other half of this field as hay. And we're going to get little bales of hay, and we're going to put them up there. We'll stuff them into one of the sheds, and then we'll use a bucket to lift up the bales of hay and tip them into the mixer wagon. And once we've done that, then we can add in a bit of silage as well, because I made a small crop of silage. If I come over here, I want to lower the star wheel, which is that one. Excellent. Right. Oops, wrong button. That button. That's the one I wanted. And come out here. Now, let's leap onto the track. Now, we've not used this one in tedder mode before. So that just... Each star wheel does it individually, and it just sort of tosses it out behind the machine. So we're going to run down this row first. Look at that. That's excellent. And we'll sort of turn right round, and we'll come back up and do it again. And, yeah, that is brilliant. I like that. So we'll go through and we'll do this with this one, and then we'll go back through and we'll row it all up. And then we're going to bale it with our little baler. Actually, you know what? I might not. I might get a different baler, because I was thinking of getting a different baler and trying one out. And there's one in particular that I've sort of had my eye on for a little while that I think would be very cool for this series. It's just I haven't got round to using it yet. The only issue is I can't find a trailer that will pick the bales up from it. So I might need to try and get a different baler that has an auto collection of bales, because it's a small baler, and I have absolutely no intention of trying to use a loader to go around and pick up hundreds of small bales lying in fields. That's just not going to happen. I wouldn't even do that for a time-lapse video because I would just find it so soul-destroying to have to go and do. I'm not doing that. I think what I will do between now and the next episode is I'll get a little bit more cultivating done and sort of get some of the headlands done. And I'll also get started on ploughing that last field. I'll at least get the headland. I'm driving all over the place here. I'm not very good at this. Get the headlands done on that last field to be ploughed, and then the Kiribits can go on and do that during our next episode. And we can sort of plug away at that. And that means that we can also get started on our fertilizer spreading. I want to do fertilizer, and I need to do some sowing. I need to sow seed in all of those fields. We've got a seeder that we can hire, or we will have when we've got some money. At the moment, we have minus 1600 euros, which is not the greatest place to be in, especially if you want to hire more machinery. So we are going to be a little bit limited. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to claw back some money so that I can hire a bit more. We might actually, no, we do, we've got a whole load of crops, so we could just sell some crops at base price, whatever that might be. I know that we sold a load of the canola and everything, but we do have a few wood chips that we could sell, because we're not going to use all of those for the beekeeping things. And we've also got other crops that we can sell as well. So the money should be okay. The money should be okay. We can always hire a slightly bigger trailer to take a few more crops if we need to. But I think that the couple trailers we got together will just, you know, a couple loads from there, that should do it, I think. So that'll take care of the money. Then, what are we going to do then? We need to sow some seeds. So we've got to plant all of the fields that we've cultivated and ploughed. And fertilizer spreading. That was the other thing I was going to come to. I need to do fertilizer spreading. In order to do that, I don't really want to stay with the Amazon spreader that I've got. And I was actually thinking that we could try the sprayer that goes with that gas truck. I did mention that before, I think. I think I'm just repeating myself now. So I apologize if I have mentioned it before. It's a job to keep up sometimes, because that was, you know, a couple of weeks ago. This thing does go all over the place a little bit, doesn't it? Drive a bit more sensibly, Frith. See, this is ridiculous. Okay, so I could use that gas truck and a sprayer, because that would be actually a pretty cool thing to do, because we haven't done any spraying at all on any of the maps yet. I don't think I've even done spraying on the time-lapse series, have I? Okay, that's decided. We will use a sprayer rather than the fertilizer spreader. But we'll do the spraying before we sow any seeds, I think. That'd be the best way to do it. So that's going to be the next task. After the cultivations, we will do the spraying using the gas truck, but we've got to hire the tanker for it. So we'll have to sell a few crops first. Then when we've done that, we'll have hay here. We've got to wait for the silage to make, so I'm not quite sure how long that's going to take. But we've got silage here. And, we're going to have to wait for the crops to grow so that we can get straw, because we've got no straw stored anywhere on the map, have we? So that's the other thing that we're going to need. Now, I'm just going to finish this bit up, and then we can see about rowing up this hay so that we can do a bit of baling. I just walked over here quick, and I brought in three loads with that one, so that has given us a bit of silage in here. I've rolled it and sheeted it down, so I don't actually say how much we got in here at the moment. It's about 80,000 litres, I think. So that's fermenting. The cattle have got grass in there. They're munching away. So at the moment, they're at 35% productivity. I don't need to worry about putting anything else in there, any more grass or anything like that, if we're getting other things for them. The mixed rations, that's what I'm talking about. But I do need to try and get straw fairly quickly. That's the sort of the clincher. I need straw for them, and I forgot to, well, I didn't forget, I just chose not to store anything back. We got our beautiful mower here. It's not actually a John Deere 956. It is actually the agromet. I wrote that down as well, and now I can't remember what it is. It is a mower. It's an old mower that was around originally, but here is the storage for the slurry and everything. We got slurry here, and we bring that one up. So that one has 12,500 litres of slurry, and then this is where the manure will go when we actually get straw in for the cattle. And Once we've got all of those in for them, I think that this shed here is where we feed them. At least I'm hoping so. That seems to be the only one that we could, or at least put straw in for them. I think it's in there. I might be wrong. We might have to just put it into the trough out here. We'll have to see. We'll have to see how that pans out. But anyway, we need to go back into the hay field now so that we can row up the hay before we go. I've unhitched it. I don't know if we've got to pick the star wheels up to move it. We better wait. We better just pick these up. So just go here. So raise the star wheels up. And then if I come round this side, move up to here. It's getting it in the right place. Right. Transport windrower mode is the one that I want it. So that will move things around. And it takes the hitch off of that wheel. And it puts the hitch over on this wheel over here. So we have to move the tractor around to the opposite side. And before I do that, I'll just lower the star wheels down again. If we get into the tractor, I can get the tractor around to the other side and back up onto it there. And this thing is very versatile, a bit like the hay bob. The hay bob is one of the wonders of modern agriculture, or not quite so modern agriculture. It was the first PTO driven one, and that one did the same. That one did the turning and the windrowing, depending on how you have the settings on the machine. I like the fact you've got that little hook on there that hooks onto the things on the wheels. So you've got that little bit there, and the bar slots into there. It's brilliant. This is so well made. This is such a fantastic mod. It really is. It's absolutely brilliant. It's very simple. The concept is very basic, but it's absolutely brilliant. I love this thing. It is fantastic. Now, if I come around the outside a bit like this, I want to go up and down this bit. So I'll sort of stay inside, and I'm just going to move up and down here. And then that bit on the outside, that'll make one windrow. If I move down here like this, and then I'll come back up the other side of it, and we should sort of have one gathering around the outside to finish it off. I do like to do this from quite a long way out of cab. It just makes the job a bit easier. Now you can see what you're doing. You get this bird's eye view. I will, in a minute, try and do a little bit of it while I'm actually on the in-cab view, if I can. Come down around here. Right, okay, let's try the in-cab or on-cab, on-tractor view. So I just assume that I need to go about there. That seems about right. It's coming up the other way that is going to be a bit more difficult to judge. I can get this bit okay. Behind us, it's all looking good. Oops. Drifting a bit there. You do have to be careful that you don't drift too far when you're driving up through something like this. Now coming around there. Now I need to turn tight round like this so that I can come back on myself almost. And now I need to be in, but I don't want to be in too far. Try about there. What's that going to get me? Yeah, that's pretty good. Down through there. Yep. So I will decide between now and next episode whether or not I use the baler that we've been using and we just gather it up with that, or if I attempt to try a new baler. But my question for this week is, do you want my this particular series? Because obviously I'm stopping Melbury Estate so that I've got time to run another series. Do you want me to stop this series next week, as in, you know, do these three for this week and then do three more for next week and then that be it, find another map and do that? Do you want me to run this for another 4 weeks? So, yeah, this week plus another three. Or do you want me to just run this series until we get to Farming Simulator 17? I would say that I would prefer not to run this until we get to all the way to 17, because that's going to be another 30 plus episodes, which, yeah, I think we're going to struggle for things to do. We're just going to be repeating ourselves the same jobs on the same map, which is going to get a little bit tedious. So I would ask if we could not do everything on this map, if we could sort of change maps. And I'm thinking there's one called, I think it's called Old Streams. I will go and have a look, but I haven't decided 100% on that yet. But I'm edging towards that I'd like to use a small map, so that I can use some of the smaller machinery in game that we don't normally use, like, you know, the vanilla stuff. There's a lot of smaller vanilla machinery that you never see get used on Let's Plays, because people start off with the smallish stuff and then they move very rapidly up to the really big stuff, and they skip out all that medium level stuff. You know, the 120 to the 180 horsepower tractors. So if I'm doing a much smaller map, it would sort of stand to reason that I would use smaller machinery, because we just wouldn't be able to fit the bigger stuff around. And I think that would be quite an interesting experience, to be able to use some of the vanilla machinery that we hardly anyone ever uses it, but get, you know, do that before we finally move on to 17. I think that would be like a nice little way to wrap it all up. But it's your vote, it's your game, you tell me what you want. Head to the comment section down below, tell me what you'd like me to do. Would you like me to run this for just a couple more weeks, run it for another 4 weeks, or do you want me to run this series until 17 comes out? And I will just finish up this little bit here before the next episode, and I'll decide what baler I'm going to be using as well, and start on the ploughing and maybe a bit more cultivation. So we've got quite a bit that we can get on with in our next episode. So if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye. And see you later.